But I've got two of my favorite people here, the cousins, Anthony Carino and John Colonnetti. And these guys are going to show us what to do with the leftover materials after you're done renovating whatever it was you were renovating. That would never happen. I make a phone call to renovate. I called these guys when I wanted to renovate this kitchen, by the way.
Yes.
So I didn't have any leftovers. They took them. But if I had done the work, let's imagine that. You're going to show us cool stuff to do with the leftovers.
And we actually had a bunch of leftover samples from the kitchen. This was some stuff that we didn't wind up using. But, you know, guys, material's expensive. So when you order it, you always order with waste, because install creates waste. So if you have enough left over, you can make some really cool projects. What we did here with this floor tile from Mirth Studio is we actually created a headboard piece.
Cool.
The number one thing you want to make sure before you start an install, figure out how much leftover square footage you have. If you have enough, you can start from the floor. If not, trim piece is going to help you raise that up and allow you to get a full backsplash, so it actually comes above the pillows, and you've got a full backsplash tile. Now, a quick little brad nail gun is going to get you trim pieces in, and then you're going to want to glue or silicone the tiles so that you don't have any nail holes in these. But it's literally just a couple of nails. And you're done. That easy.
So, guys, is this backsplash tile or floor tile when you bought it?
This is floor tile.
So, if you weren't renovating, you could buy a small amount of floor tile and do the same project.
Oh,
right?
Absolutely.
I did this in my house. I had leftover reclaimed.
I've seen that picture, actually.
The headboard I did was leftover material that was around my fireplace.
Gotcha.
So, these guys have a ton of great patterns.
That's great.
Yeah. Super cool.
Okay, are we going here next?
Yes.
All right, tile. Everybody has leftover tile. When you do a backsplash, you always have it. It's just a given. Again, like Anthony said, guys, 10 to 15% extra is what you're always gonna have because of waste. So here we have some mosaics. All you're gonna do, we have a vase, right? How cool would it be to wrap the vase in the mosaics?
You know, this is how we did our tile in our apartment in New York City. You order the pattern and the colors you want, and it comes on this stuff. It's a fake mosaic, really. You just kind of grout around it, right?
That's it. Exactly right.
That's it. So all you're going to do is you have double stick tape, guys. You're going to have
double
two pieces.
Tape.
Yep. So, Rach, you're gonna rip it there?
I don't know. I'm trying.
Okay.
I can handle
it's tape.
This.
It's tape. It's very
it's tape.
Easy. All you're going to do is just make sure that you rip it for the same exact length. And, guys,
Now you say that, I was...
Yeah, one quick note. So most tile, when it comes on a mat like this, it's 12 by 12. If you take your vase and your height is less than that, you just line it up and fold the tile along wherever the top of the vase is. That'll give you a nice cut line. Hold the tile folded and then trace it with a little Sharpie knife or a utility knife. Drop that double stick tape on like these guys are doing here, and then you just wrap it right around that glass vase.
She's got it. Rachel's got it.
Come on, Rach. Keep going.
No, guys.
No giving up.
Mine didn't work.
Don't do it like Rachel was doing it on the vase. Put it on the tile first. It makes it easy.
I did it. I put it on the tile. The vase took it.
You take the vase. You lay it down. All you're doing is connecting it. It matches up perfectly.
Rach, I'm hearing a lot.
Rach, you've almost got it. And hold on, wait a second. See, look how beautiful mine came. It came out great.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And then if you want to help me, we could style it together.
I like it better in the vase, it's in it.
No, come on. We're going to style it now. Take up the flowers.
Guys, one other note to consider as well. With a darker tile, you do have a white mat, and if you don't want to see that, you can actually go ahead and grout this. You're going to have leftover grout with your leftover tile. The grout is the super cheap part. So don't be afraid to grout this if you want to make it a little more permanent and you don't want to see all the pattern lines here.
Yeah, I'm going to keep this one.
Rachel's keeping the vase. She's keeping the vase.